Hello. Good morning, students. There is a problem on amalgamation. So the problem is separately attached by copying. I cannot type everything. So try to understand problem first. Then the solution is given in the form of PPT. So the problem is, the National Company Limited was incorporated on 1st July 2004 for the purpose of acquiring M Limited, N Limited and O Limited. The balance sheets of these companies as on 30th June 2004 are as follows. So here, if we check the attached problem, total assets of MNO company 7,40,000, 3,85,000. Similarly, liabilities. So here the liabilities include issued share capital, profit and loss account, 10% debentures, sundry creditors. So this is the balance sheet of M, N and O companies. So these three companies are being acquired by the other company called National Company Limited on 1st July 2004. And the additional information here, average annual profits before debenture interest. So the profits include interest on debentures, that is July 2003 to June 2004. So here in M Limited, so the annual average profits before paying debenture interest, 90,000, 1,12,000. 20,000, 50,000. The other information is professional valuation of tangible assets on 30th June 2004. M Limited is 6,20,000, N Limited 4,80,000, O Limited is 3,60,000. This is the revaluation of tangible assets. So here, and other additional information is, the directors in the negotiations agreed that, number one, the recorded goodwill of N Limited is valueless. In the given problem, the goodwill is only for N Limited, that is 60,000. So they are not going to consider this goodwill if the national company wants to acquire. This is the first condition. Number two, the other assets of M Limited are worth ₹30,000. Actually, in the given problem, other assets of M Limited is 2 lakhs. They are not considering 2 lakhs as other assets for M Limited. They are considering as 30,000. For the rest of the companies N and O, other assets value are as it is. Third one is the valuation on 30th June 2004 in respect of tangible fixed assets should be accepted. So the revaluation of tangible assets are 6,20,000, 4,80,000, 3,60,000. For M, N and O companies respectively, this should be accepted. These adjustments are to be made by the individual company before the completion of the acquisition. So these are the explanations. Then second one is, the acquisition agreement provides for the issue of 12% unsecured debentures to the value of net assets of companies N limited, M limited and O limited. That means here the purchase consideration is to be paid in the form of issuing toll percentage debentures to the value of net assets. Whatever the net assets value is available, for that debentures are to be issued. And for the issue of rupees 10 nominal value equity shares, for the capitalized average profit of each acquired company in excess of net assets contributed, the capitalization rate is established. That means here, whatever the excess value over the net assets available, that should be capitalized at the rate of 10%. For that the equity shares, the nominal value of rupees 10 are to be issued. So these are the two conditions. So here, as per this problem, you are required to calculate purchase consideration that is to be payable first. And you have to show discharge of purchase consideration. So here, first we will try to calculate purchase consideration. Consideration can be calculated as follows. You see, this is slide. Consideration in the form of toll percentage debentures are to be issued. How do you calculate purchase consideration? Here, there are certain values, tangible assets, what we agreed in the negotiations should be taken, and also the goodwill is for N company should not be considered. The other assets of M Limited should be considered as only 30,000. So according to the agreement, the values are to be taken, then the total net assets are to be calculated first. Because as per the net assets, we have to issue debentures. How do you calculate net assets? Assets minus liabilities. First, you see the M Limited tangible assets 6,20,000, other assets 30,000. Total assets for M Limited is 6,50,000. Similarly, N Limited 4,80,000 tangible assets, 2,80,000. Total is 7,60,000. For O Limited, the total assets are 4,45,000. So when we obtain total value of the assets, then we have to identify liabilities. So here in the table B explains liabilities. A explains assets, B explains liabilities. Liabilities include sundry creditors. Sundry creditors of M Limited 80,000, 10% debentures 70,000, total liabilities 1,50,000. So assets minus liabilities, that is C, net assets. So net assets A minus B. From the assets, if you deduct liabilities, we will get net assets. So the net assets of M Limited is 5 lakh. Similarly for N, 7,60,000 assets, 1,30,000 liabilities, net assets are 6,30,000. Coming to O Limited, that the net assets are 3,70,000. Now here, according to the agreement, we need to issue toll percent debentures to the value of net assets. So toll percent debentures with the value of 5 lakhs are to be issued for M Limited, because the net assets value is 5 lakhs. So debentures are to be issued 5 lakhs for M Limited. For unlimited, 6,30,000 debentures are to be issued. For O-limited, also 12% debentures to the value of 3,70,000 are to be issued. So in this table, we calculated first net assets. Net assets are assets minus liability. Whatever the changes taken place for the assets, according to that, we have to identify the value of the assets. Similarly, the liabilities, then we need to calculate net assets. So as per the net assets value, 12% debentures are issued for M, N and O limited. So this is the first slide. And coming to the next one, we need to issue the equity shares. Equity shares are to be issued for the value which is in excess of net assets. So here net assets we have identified. Then what is the excess amount over the net assets we need to calculate? You see here, average annual profit before debenture interest. So here that we need to calculate. In first you see only one company, M Limited, 90,000 rupees. If you deduct the debentures, debenture interest is 10% on average annual profit before paying the debenture interest is 90,000. Debenture interest at 10% payable to debenture holders is 7,000. Therefore, profit after debenture interest, here D for debentures, A minus B, 83,000. So from that is the profit after debenture interest. So the capitalization rate, that means the actual profit available is to be capitalized. How do you calculate capitalization of the average profit? C divided by D. That means for 10 rupees, it is 100. For 83,000 rupees profit, what should be the value? So according to this, if you calculate, we'll get 8,30,000 is capitalized profit. So when the capitalized profit is 8,30,000, net assets taken over for M Limited is 5 lakhs. What is the profit in excess of net assets now? Excess of capitalized profit over net assets are 3,30,000. So for 3,30,000 rupees, we need to issue 10 rupees nominal value of each issue in case of N Limited. Similarly, N Limited, that the capitalized profit is 2 lakh, net assets 6,30,000, 5,30,000 is excess of capitalized profit. Similarly, capitalized profit in case of O Limited, it is 90,000. So it is very clear what value of equity shares we need to issue in case of M, N, and O. So in the two tables, we clearly explained the value of debentures are to be issued, M, N, and O, the value of equity shares to be issued for M, N, and O. So here, we have to show clearly discharge. How do you discharge the purchase consideration? Very clear, summary of purchase consideration here. In the first slide, we identified 12% debentures of National Limited at rupees 100 each, which is the worth of 5 lakhs. For M, 6,30,000 for N, 3,70,000 for O. Similarly, equity shares of rupees 10 each 3,30,000 in the second slide, we identified what worth of equity shares we need to issue. According to second slide, for M Limited, this is equity shares 3,30,000, N Limited 5,70,000, O Limited 90,000. The total consideration in the form of debentures and equity shares to be payable to M Limited is 8,30,000, N Limited 12,00,000, O Limited 4,60,000. I hope you can clearly understand in the given problem, that is National Limited Company is acquiring the other companies M, N and O. So M, N and O companies are transfer companies. National Limited is a transfer company. So here we can also see in the given problem it is not clear whether it is amalgamation in the nature of merger. But when that the values of the assets and liabilities are changed automatically, we can confirm this is the amalgamation in the nature of the purchase. So according to the given directions, we identified what is total purchase consideration to be payable to the shareholders of M, N and O. Thank you all.